0, 0, the vertex is somewhere here. I'll call it h and k. So if the parabola was right here, and the focus was right here, 0p, and the directrix was right here, y equals minus p. So all of these have been shifted that way. So you first shift the vertex at x equals h here, and then you shift the k with the y value to k. Okay? So where is your new focus then?
P or p plus
h.
H and?
K plus p.
K plus p. So you shift the 0 to h, and the p you shifted by k. So it's somewhere here at h and p plus k. That's where your focus is now. Your focus is always aligned with the vertex in the way. And this line is shifted where?
Up
by k. So you take minus p plus k, so it's going to be somewhere here. I don't know. Somewhere here. This is y equals minus p plus k. So you see, if I have the unshifted conic, and that's what I put there, you shift by just adding to every x h and to every y you add the k. That's it. That's how you shift. So if the vertex is at 0, 0, it's shifted, it becomes h and k. If the focus is at 0p or p0, if at 0p, then I shift, it becomes h, we add h and then p plus k. If the directrix is y equals minus p, well, I only shift the y value, so I add
k.
So you just need to know these two values. Once you know them, all the other old ones, you add h and you add k to the x and y. And that's the same for the ellipses, you see? This is the unshifted, you see x and y are unshifted. But when I shift, you see x is shifted by h and y is shifted by k. So the center becomes hk. The focus was plus or minus c, it becomes plus or minus c plus h and then k. And the vertex is also plus or minus a plus h. Same thing for the hyperbolas. You see, non-shifted, you shift, add k and add h. That's it. Okay. So, just looking at it, just looking without the x and without the h and the k, identify if I have a flat or a horizontal, you know, along the ellipse first. So you know if I'm on the x or the y, and then you add. So we have four of them here. Okay. The first one it says x squared equals y plus one. Where is the new vertex? X is x shifted? No, so 0. Is y shifted? Yes, by what?
By -1.
-1. Remember, it's y minus k, so y minus -1 gives you the shift. It should be y minus k, always. Okay. If I have a plus, 1 is y minus k, -1. So k is -1 here. Okay? So this one, it opens up, down, right, or left?
This one.
Up. It opens up. It opens up this way. So everything is on the y-axis.
Yeah.
Okay? So this is the unshifted one. It was at 0, 0. Now it becomes that. What was the unshifted focus? Where was it? It was at 0 and p. Oh, we need to find p first. How do I find p? Remember, 4p equals, what is the coefficient of y? 1. 4p equals 1. So p equals
1
over 4. Yeah, always find p. Okay. Now, the unshifted focus was at 0, 1 over 4, and the directrix was at y equals negative 1 over 4. Okay? It will go by the y. So now, if I shift, where is the new focus?
0.
0? Yeah, 1 fourth minus 1, which is negative 3 fourths. And where is the new directrice? So you add negative 1 to that.
Negative 1 over 4 minus 1 would be negative 5 over 4.
Identifying the parabola, we find the new vertex, the new focus, and the new directrice.